Hi guys, and welcome back to Subnautica. Remember from the last episode, we just returned to our ship, and we are then going to get into it. Okay, message coming through straight away. Let's get onto that. Let's check our med kit. Come on, open it, empty it, store it. That's the way. And you see how all those pods are moved to one side? That's gone and affected the actual balance of the ship. So we're going to move those off and balance those up in a sec. Meantime, as you can see, storage is a problem. Computer chip. I need some coral, silver, and quartz. I also need knife. Nothing to sort out there. I also need a knife, and that's basically silicon and titanium. Okay. Drink some of this water, make some space. That's the signal we just got from the new pod. We'll store it for the moment, we'll have a look at it after. Silver's safe. Let's see if we've got any space down here. Store one. Get a bit of storage in there. Balance the ship out. See it move? Okay, not too bad so far. It's pretty reasonable. We'll move that one across a little bit. That's better. Okay, so what do we need? We've got nothing to make food, so that's fine. Tools. We need the survival knife, that's fine. Where'd I put the silicon? Copy. Okay. Oh well. Go get some more. I thought I made a couple of pieces of silicon. One lubricant and two silicon, but obviously I'm deluding myself again. Anyway, there's one of the creatures. Nice, friendly little chap. Come up and give you a smack with the tail. Or his beak. Yeah, I hear you. Yeah, go on. I'm going. Yes, run away. Run away. I'm out of here. Up, go on. Go, 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 go. Very handy little tool for getting away. I've had them come and stalk me over at my life pod and my base. They followed me back one day and they harassed me every time I went outside. Even standing on the deck, they were trying to get up on the deck, jump out of the water to get me. Didn't like me, I don't know why. Anyway, bit of fun. Okay, so there's a knife. I need that knife to get the coral. Without that knife, I can't get the coral. Okay, let's see if we can store some of this stuff. I'm gonna have trouble. Come on. Gotta be space somewhere. Okay, let's just go get the coral. This is red table coral. There's purple table coral. Make sure you pick it up. If you just chop it, it's just going to fall to the bottom. You have to click to pick it up. Okay, so now we have all the components. Just check it again. Come on. Done that. That's what I want. Computer chip and a battery. Computer chips, table coral, silver, ore, and quartz. And the battery, of course, is copper and acid. Copper, silver, that's the silver. That's salt, I want quartz. Bingo, one computer chip. And what I need, a battery. Yep. I don't think I've got acid fish, I've got mushrooms, I've only got one. I've used it. I'll grab him, there's one just outside the door. And yeah, we'll duck outside the door. Straight down. Plenty around the place. We've never run short of these things. Bingo! One habitat builder. We can now start to build the basics of our base. Okay guys, that wasn't too bad. That was pretty straightforward. Play the message.
This is Avery Quinn of Trading Ship Sunbeam. Aurora, do you read? Over. Still nothing. These old Terra ships, they run out of engine grease. They send an S. So what? Go offer to help? You got me. Aurora, I'm out on the far side of the system. It's going to take more than a week to reach your position. Do you still need our assistance? I'll try them again tomorrow. See what the long-range scan picks up in the meantime.
Okay, we just picked up another message, Life Pod 7.
Our profit margin running errands for all Terra.
We got a room space problem, but we can sort this out. Because we are going to build the base. We start off, we have to be very conservative in what we're going to do, but all I want is somewhere I can build storage lockers, and then I can store the materials. And then we're going to go for a little search to gather some more blueprints. Okay, so speed this a little bit along. Okay, make a bit of space. Out we go. Inventory secured. Let's gather some of this stuff we may need. Fair few nodes down here. Can't argue with copper. Love the copper. Titanium, lead. Yeah, egg. We don't want that. Keep your eyes out. Keep them peeled, guys. Caution. 30 oxygen. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining. Oh, there's a bubble over there. I'll go stand on that for a second.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Now, those creep vines, there's a sign there that says you can cut them with a knife. You can do that. Don't need them at this moment, but we can just chop with a knife. That's a different job than the seeds or the pods. We'll get to those a little bit later on. There's a difference between the pods and cutting the vines. Okay, there's a creature. Crashfish just gone off and blew up. One of the stinky things. 56 seconds. Crashfish pod down there, it's open with a seed hanging out. And this is where we're going to stick our base. It's going to take a little bit of a fiddle around to get it to the right spot. I don't want the actual base to be half in the water, half out. I do want this base to stick slightly above it. And then the water won't slosh around on the bottom of the actual base. If I'm half and half, then the water will be half the depth, and it means those little pods are unusable. So I just got to fiddle around a bit here to get it to stick out as high as possible. Doesn't matter about a little bit of a flush on this. If it's not high enough, I can't put down some of the things I want to put on it outside. So I don't want it under the water. So I want to get it above the water. So a bit of effort, bit of work. That's not too bad. That's pretty good. Oh, rats, I moved. Come on. Yeah, I think that's okay. Oh, I didn't bring enough titanium. Okay, so that's going to be okay. We're just going to build our base right there. Let's get back, get some titanium, and get on with this. I'm going to just flow this through pretty quick. Nothing exciting happening apart from putting down the base. Oh, stink bomb attack. Thanks, fella. That was nice of you. I really, really enjoyed that. Yeah, yep, I'm hungry. Come on. Let's get this down first. And we better catch some fish. I know I have plenty of water. It's just fish that we're looking. And look at them all. Millions of them. Let's get this one into us, and then we'll go catch some more. This will restore our food up, and it'll also put our hydration levels up just over the 20%, which is fine.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Cool, now let's go hunting some more.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the aim here, of course, is to put the base, one of the foundation, well, the bases components on the top of that. Sometimes you can manage to pull it off this way, and sometimes you just have to be a little tricky. Patience is a virtue, but if it doesn't work, there are other means, and we'll get to that in a sec. Yeah, I know I can put it down low. That's one of the alternatives. But if I can get away with it, I want it up top to start. Surprisingly, the manufacturing costs of these components is all the same. I think they should be slightly different. That's again, that would be a modification to the game, where the smaller single components would use less titanium than the multi four-way one, for example. I think that should use like 3 titanium as opposed to the straight one, which uses 2. Obviously, there's more components there, that's all. Okay. I can't get it up there. Okay, we're going to go for the old style. I'm going to stick it down the bottom here. No, can't get a lower one. Rightio. Bring it over. Stick it down. And sometimes you can use this to get up. I'm trying to put one on top. One on top works just as well. No, it won't do. I need to complete that first. Can't stick one on top. No. Not working for me today. Oh well, let's see if we can. No, it's not working at all. That's a bit weird. Okay. We're going to have to try to jump up. Come on. Did it. From the end, there you go. Problem solved. Foot the four-way down. We want it towards our base. Come on, behind you. Behind. Okay. That's there. We can now put an extension on that. And I will want a T-piece. I have to step back, I'm in the way. Turn it round, and there we go. Get rid of this other one, that will give us our resources back. And you notice the deconstruct for me is scroll lock. I found the Q button way too easy to destroy things by mistake. I jump in through the door here with the constructor in my hand, and I ended up losing a wall cabinet full of important materials. Just by accidentally pushing the Q instead of the W button. So I've changed it to scroll lock for me. You're probably a bit more apt with the controls and the keys, but you only have to lose one cabinet full of silver and gold and all those cool tools to go and change it. Particularly the silver. The silver was a nasty loss. Everything else you can reconstruct, but finding the silver is a pain. Okay, I can put a window there. I don't want to, I just wanted to see. We're in, we have no power here. To create power, we're going to put down solar. And that was the main aim, to get that platform above the waterline. One, solar. I am told you can put solar in underwater, which is amazing. But the other one is I'm going to hopefully get some outdoor gardens and grow some plants. And I need that above the water level. Okay, let's gather up some stuff. Another message. Gather up some stuff here. And we'll go and power it up. Glass. That's interesting. I haven't made one of those before. I'll have to look at that later on. Ah, oh, man. Didn't need glass, I needed the quartz. What an idiot. I was thinking glass. Solar panel, glass, makes sense. Caution. To me.
Mild dehydration detected.
Yeah, thirsty, as always. Okay, let's try this again.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Gonna need food soon. Okay, let's try this again. What am I doing? Quartz, that's right, got it. Okay, so across we'll go. Now, the reason I have that window just there is in order to get up that level, I just have to jump in through that hatch. I can't just pop onto the side of this. Well, I haven't been able to. But let's get some solar power down. It doesn't really matter which way you face it in this game. I like to pretend, and so I'm going to have it facing out. And I'll put this one down this way, and I'll put another one facing another direction. There's one. And you go. Power's on.
Power restored. All primary systems online.
Excellent. Let's boost the power. Stick another one right back there. Beauty. We'll put some more power in later on.
Well,
there you
aboard,
go. Power is now a total capacity of 100, and we are sitting at 15 and climbing. Here's what I'm after. These wall lockers. Fabricator, I have to get that. That's going to take silver. And a bit of silver on that one. Wall lockers, I'm going to need more quartz. Aquarium, I'm going to need a bit more stuff than that. In fact, I need a whole shell. I have to go find. So, fabricator, definitely need some silver, but my main thing at the moment is I need sufficient quartz to build some wall lockers to store stuff. Also, food 16%, water's 32%. As we go hunting for this quartz, we'll also grab some fish. That was a tongue twister for me. Grab some fish. Fish on chops. Titanium, need titanium and quartz and food. Titanium, quartz and food. Never let one swim by. The voice for this, of course, is just so you know, is recorded on a separate channel from the actual video. The sound for the game and the video is recorded, going to be recorded, or has been recorded on one channel. My voice is actually on another channel, and I'm trying this out to see if make it easier to clean up in regards to any background noise or editing. It will be a pain to sync it again, but that's just life. But sometimes some of the noise is coming through a real pain. So I'm just trying this out, see how it works. Got him. And hopefully that it will work out easier and cleaner to put it back together. Resources are not a storage of resources are not an issue now, so I won't be passing them up. Eleven health. I got time. Water's fine. Gotta find the right door. There's my hatch. Okay, let's put a couple of these cupboards down.
Emergency. Starvation imminent.
Yeah, I know.
Immediately.
Excellent. One. And that's all the titanium I had. That sucks. I can lay it out, though. Yep. Okay. Rightio. So the next bit's going to be basically just getting some food, cooking it up, and then moving some of the resources. So I'm going to just let this accelerate along. Don't want glass.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Okay, with those cooked fish, the pepper fish gives you the most. The other fish give you less energy or food source and water source. So those pepper fish are the key main ones. The other options that were there was actually salting the fish. And I can't remember whether I've said it before, but if you salt the fish, they will last a lot longer. They don't go rotten. However, it does have a negative effect on your hydration levels. It ends up being a negative hydration. So food will increase, but hydration will drop down marginally. Not really a problem. Again, it's basically salting them, so if you're going away, you can take some food with you, that won't go rotten.
Aurora, this is Sunbeam again. We just picked up a massive debris field at your location. I didn't know how bad, how many of... I didn't know. We're now en route to your location. We're gonna bring you home. Sunbeam out.
What else can I say? We're a six-seater, and we aren't even slightly equipped to handle this? Our pilot last attempted a planet landing in the Academy simulator? Oh, it's a bad situation, but so are all the alternatives.
Okay, so we now have got storage. Beauty, we have two storage lockers down. We'll put some more down in a sec, but basically the food, the water and the meds go into that one. The fire extinguisher and the flares can go into that one. And the other one just by the door is going to be a main tool locker. So this one there is basically our rations. Spell it right, R-A-T-I-O-N. And that's our ration kit. And the other one there will be for equipment. Straight by the door for the equipment. Now don't put too many down unless you know which way you're going to build. For example, I'm going to come in through the front door and turn left, and that will be into a multi-purpose building when I get the blueprint. And when I turn right, that will be going nowhere. In fact, that's out on the deck, and that's right where the solar panels are. But yes, that wall just to my left there is actually the way out to the multi-purpose pod that I will be putting there. Down the end, we'll go straight out to another pod, and where I have that glass door at the moment, going out onto the deck, that will actually move in a while. But for the moment, that's fine. One of the things when you deconstruct something, you really should have a time limit on it. And before you get back all your resources, as it is now, I can deconstruct anything any time, and I get it back 100% of the resources. That's pretty cool, except it can be a bit advantageous. You should lose something, I think. Certainly you lose battery power. Maybe the deconstruct should use more power than the create or something. I don't know, something like that, some kind of penalty. There's nothing there at the moment. I don't mind if it doesn't change, but it kind of means you can modify things and do a few little odds and sods I'll show you later, further down the trap, that I don't think it was meant to be that way. Yeah, well, some of these little things I'll use to my advantage until such time as they're changed. And I'll show you those in later episodes. Okay. That's just showing us I can now cure that type of fish. Electronics, I can make copper wire. For that computer chip, I need more silver. And for that wiring kit, I need silver for that. So we've got some silver to collect in order to get those manufacturing pods onto the other one. So we need to get one of those on the other ship. I missed it. Go down. Down, 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 down. There it is. Wiring kit, computer chip, and two titanium. Okay, silver, silver, and more silver. I have one silver. Now I need two more as a minimum. Okay, I know where some is. But again, we're going to have to gather it up. Two for the wiring kit. Got gold, but it won't let me use the advanced wiring kit. Okay, just sorting this out, just organising it. Just going to move it across to the other hub. That will take care of all the business in this episode. Nothing exciting going to happen apart from moving equipment. So I'm going to speed this along. And then I'll see you in the next episode. Unless, of course, something dramatic happens in the next couple of seconds. And I think you'll find either hilarious, and that will be me getting mashed by a creature, or something I think of particular interest. Okay, so that's it, guys. And yep, we're going to move it to the other ship, put in some more cabinets, and then we're going to go off on a little spectacular hunt. Silver and more Rex. Okay, do I have everything? Cool, I'm out of here, guys, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.